Ciao ragazzi, buongiorno, come stai? Tutto bene? Spero di sì. Benvenuti alla prossima lezione di italiano. Hello everyone, welcome back to your Italian online lessons. This is the next lesson that you'll be doing on the weather. If you remember last time, I said that this lesson would have weather phrases in, but also it would be revision of numbers, okay? Because you'll be learning how to say what the temperature is. So let's start off with some numbers then. I numeri. Che numero è? Ok, che numero è? Allora, pensate che numero è? Guardate la lista. So first of all, just have a look at all of the numbers that are there on the screen and see if you can think off the top of your head how you would say those numbers. So just make a mental note as you go through how you're getting on, okay? Which ones do you know? Which ones are you confident with? So just pause the video there while you have a think about those numbers. Ok, allora continuiamo. Ora ascoltate che numero è. Ok, ascoltate. So now keeping the same set of numbers up on the screen, you're going to listen to me say eight of them. Okay, so just eight numbers that I say will be the ones off the screen. Okay, if you want, you can listen and try and find the number, and that will confirm to you that you've maybe got the right one. If you want to make it harder for yourself, then you can just listen to what I'm saying without looking at the screen and just write down the number that you think I've said. Okay, but either way, it's testing your listening skills and your knowledge of numbers. Okay, allora cominciamo. First one then, numero uno. Let's start with an easy one. Sei. Sei. Numero due, the second question. Ventisei. Ventisei. Numero tre, 89. 89. Numero quattro, 16. 16. Numero 5, 43. 43. Numero 6, 47. 47. Numero 7, 76. 76. E numero 8, 110. 110. Va bene. Ok, vediamo le risposte. So our answers, number one, you should have written down 6. Number two is 26. 3 is 89. 4 is 16. 5 is 43. 6 is 47. 7 is 76. And the last one, number eight, was 110. Okay, so hopefully you've gotten okay with that. If not, obviously you know that numbers is something that you'll be needing to work on, and hopefully today's lesson will help a little bit with that. Okay, allora, che tempo fa? Qual è la temperatura? Okay, so two questions there. Che tempo fa? We did last time, it means what's the weather like. Qual è la temperatura? Ovviamente in inglese, what is the temperature? So you're describing the weather, and also, as I said, we're revising numbers so you can say what the temperature is. Ok, allora i numeri vi ricordate? So, can you remember these numbers? So, these are just your units, okay? So, they're in tens. So, just go through in your head. Can you remember what they all are? Pause the video now, fa una pausa. E le risposte? Allora, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Ok? So, with the numbers, once you get to 100, it's nice and easy because you take the word for 100, which is cento, and if we wanted to say 110, you would just put the number 10 after it. So 110, 120, 120, 130, 130. Ok? Va bene. Ok, allora vediamo l'Italia. Ecco la mappa d'Italia. Ok? Questo è Roma, Napoli, nel sud c'è Crotone, nel nord Milano. Ok, e la temperatura a Genova è 21 gradi. Ok, allora guardate la mappa, ecco Genova, 21 gradi. Ok, allora in inglese, the temperature at Genova is 21 degrees. Ok, so that is how you would say the temperature in a place. So, for example, if we wanted to look down in the south, nel sud, Crotone. Okay, if you want to say the temperature at Crotone is 24, have a think how you would say that. Ovviamente la temperatura a Crotone è 24 gradi. Ok, what about Palermo? La temperatura a Palermo è 21 gradi. Okay, what about if we have a little look at Venezia? Okay, so Venice. La temperatura a Venezia è 19 gradi. Okay, so that's how you say the temperature at a place. So gradi, okay, is obviously what makes it clear that you're talking about the temperature, just 21 on its own. You probably wouldn't hear, you'd have to have the word gradi at the end. Okay, so like degrees. Va bene? Allora, qual è la temperatura oggi? So what is the temperature today? Remember that word oggi. Un esempio, la temperatura oggi è 10 gradi. Allora, in inglese, the temperature today is 10 degrees. Ok? E ci sono 10 esempi. Got 10 examples there for you to work through. Allora, parlate in italiano, per favore. Parlate in italiano. So say all these out loud in Italian. Ok? Pause the video while you do it. So you're going to be replacing what is in blue here, 10 gradi, with the numbers that are there. Okay, so go back to your notes if you need to have help with these numbers. Otherwise, off you go. Oh, and by the way, have a little think about how you might say minus 10. You have done the word minus. Okay, so have a think about what that might be. Va bene, allora avete finito? Sì? Okay, risposte. So our answers. Each time you should have been saying the phrase la temperatura oggi è, okay? And then if we just run through these numbers nice and quickly. So 18 is 18, 82 is 82, 4 is 4, 28 is 28, not 28, but 28. You get rid of the I, you don't have the two vowels next to each other. 7 is 7, 52 is 52, 91, 91. Again, you get rid of the A at the end of 90 and it becomes 91. Same with 61, 61. Now, for those of you who've worked this out, well done. Remember the word for minus, okay, is meno. You did it when we were learning the time. So if you wanted to say quarter to 12, for example, you'd have to say 12 minus a quarter, meno un quarto. And that's the word you need here. So it would be meno 10. And finally, 150 would be 150. Okay, obviously a ridiculous number there, but just to practice with your numbers. Va bene, continuiamo e facciamo un po' di revisione. Okay, so a little bit of revision from the phrases that you did last time. So, che tempo fa? What's the weather doing? So, a reminder then, fa bel tempo, meaning the weather is fine. Okay, but what about all the other ones? Fa brutto tempo, fa caldo, fa freddo. Okay, allora fa una pausa. E pensate cosa significa in inglese? What do they all mean in English? Okay, so we have the weather's bad, it's hot, it's cold. Then we move on to the phrases that start with che. That's how you pronounce it, not che, but che. So c'è il sole, it's sunny. Then we have it's windy, it's foggy, and it's stormy. Then we have è nuvoloso, it is. This is where my PowerPoint jumps around. So we get two before that one. So there we go. It's cloudy. Piove, it's raining. Nevica, it's snowing. And gela is it's freezing. Okay, now if you missed the last lesson, you may want to do a bit of practice learning these phrases. Okay, so this is what you're going to be making sure that you're really confident with by the time you've done these couple of lessons on weather. Okay, so if you're happy to move on, vediamo un esercizio d'ascolto. So I'm going to say a weather phrase and you need to jot down the number of the picture, okay, that corresponds with what you hear. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll just do six of these phrases. So you're not going to hear all 12, just six. And I think we'll just make sure that we get this right. So grab a pen. And if you can write down for me A, B, C, D, E, F, okay, and then we'll just make sure that when I'm saying these phrases, you write a number next to the letter. So your first question, A, you'll write a number next to it. Okay? Allora, frase A. So phrase A, which picture corresponds with this? Nevica. Nevica. Frase B. C'è il sole. C'è il sole. Frase C. So phrase C. Fa freddo. Fa freddo. Frase D. So phrase D. C'è un temporale. C'è un temporale. Frase E. Gella. Gella. E finalmente frase F. Piove. Piove. Va bene, le risposte. So answers, of course you can go back and do that exercise again if you need to rehear it. Phrase A, frase A, I said nevica, okay, so that was number 10, numero 10. Frase B, I said that it was sunny, okay, c'è il sole, so picture 5. Frase C, I said it was cold, fa freddo, and that is number 2, numero 2. Frase D, I said that it was stormy, so c'è un temporale, allora numero 8, number 8. Frase E, I said from letter E, gella, gella meaning it's freezing, okay, numero 11, so number 11. E finalmente F, frase F, piove, piove means it's raining, allora la risposta è numero 9, okay, number 9 is your answer for that last one. Okay, so just to recap then for these images. If anyone's still not got them 100% clear in their head, running through them from 1 to 12 very quickly. Ascoltate e ripetete. Fa caldo, fa freddo, fa bel tempo, fa brutto tempo. C'è il sole, c'è il vento, c'è la nebbia, c'è un temporale. Piove, nevica. Gella e nuvoloso. Ok, finito. Allora, ora fate un cruciverba. Ok, so you now have a crossword to have a go at. So all your clues are at the bottom. Ok, your clues are in English. Allora, sono in inglese. E voi dovete scrivere in italiano. Ok, you have to complete the crossword in Italian. Completate il cruciverba in italiano. So, for example, two across, the weather is horrible. You can see that's the clue there. Think about what that phrase is and fill it in Italian across here. Okay, so if you get it right, what you'll find is that your clues will all line up nicely, so all your letters will be in the right place. If you think that one of your clues isn't fitting, it's probably because you've got the wrong word. Okay, allora. Fa una pausa, ok? Fa una pausa, pensate e scrivete in italiano. So take a pause and have a go at writing these out in Italian and we'll look through the answers shortly. Ok, allora facciamo le risposte orizzontali. So we'll do the horizontal ones first, the across clues. Numero due, the weather is horrible. You should have fa brutto tempo, going across there. Numero tre, it's snowy, is nevica. That should have fit in here. Okay, numero quattro, what's the weather like? Okay, it's the question that was at the start of the lesson. It's che tempo fa? The weather is nice. Numero sette, fa bel tempo. Numero nove, fa caldo. Numero dodici, c'è vento. C'è vento. Ok, your down clues. It's stormy. So this one here. C'è un temporale. C'è un temporale. Numero 5, più facile, a little bit easier, a bit shorter. It's cold, is fa freddo. Numero 6, it's sunny, is c'è. Where are we? Number 6 here. C'è il sole. Numero otto, okay, I like, just throwing an opinion phrase in there for you so you can talk about what type of weather you like. For example, I like the sun. Mi piace is the phrase you need. Mi piace il sole, I like the sun. Mi piace is spelled MEPIACE, mi piace. Numero dieci, it's rainy, it's piove, ecco, piove. E numero undici, when. Is a word that we've not done for a while. For example, when is your birthday? And it is quando. Okay, the reason that word is there is because it's useful to say things like, when it's rainy, I like to stay in the house, or when it's rainy, I like to go to the cinema. Okay, quando. And that would go in here. Quando. Perfetto. Okay, allora, qual è la temperatura e che tempo fa? So let's combine the two. So what the temperature is and what the weather is like. Okay, so for this, you're going to need to take a pause, have a think about the number and the type of weather. As I've said, feel free to go back through your notes at any point to help you with this or go back through the video. But the phrases in blue are the ones that you're changing. So the number will change, okay, and the weather will change. Just notice, by the way, just to be kind, I've given you 10 as your first one, which matches with dieci. So that is one way you won't change it. Take a pause now, fa una pausa e scrivete in italiano qual è la temperatura e che tempo fa. Vediamo le risposte se avete finito. Ok, allora, numero uno, this is what you're changing it to. Okay, now I've not written out the whole phrase, I've just given you the number, okay, because your first phrase will just remain la temperatura è 10 gradi, and instead of fa freddo, you should have had è nuvoloso. Numero due, la temperatura è 76 gradi e fa caldo. Numero tre, la temperatura è 4 gradi e gela. Quattro, la temperatura è 89 gradi e c'è il sole. Cinque, la temperatura è 7 gradi e piove. Sei, la temperatura è 51 gradi e c'è vento. Numero 7, la temperatura è 100 gradi e fa molto caldo e c'è il sole. Numero 8, la temperatura è 45 gradi e c'è un temporale. Numero 9, la temperatura è meno 10 gradi, gela e nevica. E finalmente 10, la temperatura è 150 gradi e I've missed out, it's boiling. E bollente is how you say it's boiling. E c'è il sole. Okay, boiling isn't a phrase that we have done. Okay, but c'è il sole you should have. Okay, allora facciamo un altro esercizio d'ascolto. Okay, notice the slight typo there. It should in fact say ascoltate. Okay, there's a T missing. But for each question, you're going to listen out for someone offering to go somewhere. So it's an invitation to do something, which is what we did a few lessons back. If, by the way, you've missed any of the lessons, you can find them all on the Consilium YouTube page. So if you've missed that lesson, it was called Inviti. Okay, so you can find out that if you want to go back. So you're making a note of where is the person being invited to go. The second thing is if they accept or decline it and give a reason why. So for example, do they accept it? And if so, why? And finally, there'll be a phrase to do with the weather or the temperature. Okay, so just make yourself maybe a little table. Okay, with three columns, one which is for the place, one is for if they accept or decline, and one which is to do with the weather. And there will only be three questions. Okay, three questions, because there's quite a lot of information for you to jot down in each case. Okay. Allora, andiamo. Let's give it a go then. So I will obviously be reading both parts, okay? So you've got to assume that there are two people in this conversation, even though I am reading both bits. Okay, numero uno. Salve, ciao. Vuoi andare al cinema con me? Sì, mi piacerebbe molto, perché fa brutto tempo e la temperatura è soltanto 2 gradi. Numero 2. Buonasera, vuoi andare alla spiaggia con me? No, no grazie, non mi va. Fa caldo, ma c'è troppo vento. Numero 3. Buongiorno, io vado al castello. Ti piacerebbe venire con me? Il castello? No grazie, è molto noioso. E inoltre fa freddo e piove. Ok, allora è finito. So So there we go, that's your listening. Go back, listen to it again, okay, so that you hear it for a second time. And remember, you're trying to write for each listening exercise. Where is it that they are being invited to? Do they accept and why? And what do they say about the weather? Okay, vediamo. So our invitation for the first one was for the cinema, il cinema. They accepted. They said that they wanted to go. And the reason why was they said, well, yes, it'd be nice to go because the weather's horrible and it's only 2 degrees. Number two, the invite was to the beach. Okay, la spiaggia was what you heard. And the person said, no, they didn't feel like it. Okay, said it's hot, but it's too windy. Remember the word troppo means too. And the final one, the invite was to the castle, il castello. And the person said, no, they didn't want to. And because it would be boring, and they said, and what's more, so inoltre is what you heard. Inoltre means what's more, it's cold and it's rainy. Okay, if you struggled with that or you didn't get many of those answers, maybe now you've got the answers in front of you, you can go back and have another listen and see whether or not you can now pick out those pieces of information. Okay. Okay, finalmente, per finire. So the last thing then, I want you to now have a go at doing this. So normally you would do this with a partner, okay, and you are being asked to name as many types of weather as you can in Italian without stopping to pause. So if you're doing it in a pair, you would start and you would say something like c'è il sole. Your partner would then have their turn, they would say c'è vento, then it would be back to you, you'd say piove. Okay, if you have a partner or you can find a partner, then you can do that. So it's like a game of a table tennis where it goes backwards and forwards, and the person who pauses first, okay, or can't think of one would lose. Alternatively, I'm assuming most of you are sitting here on your own doing this, in which case you just need to challenge yourself to see how many types of weather you can name without stopping to pause, and that means you're doing it without your notes in front of you. Okay, reading them out loud isn't particularly difficult, so don't do that, that's cheating. And the second thing, because today was all about numbers, see if you can count to 100, okay, again, without any help and without stopping. Okay, allora abbiamo finito, però ora impariamo. Okay, so we've finished the lesson, now it's time for you to learn. Impariamo means let's learn. So Quizlet and Educandy are the two sites that you can go to practice using different vocab games. You can find the links to these on the virtual classroom site that you have got on class charts today. So if you are feeling quite confident with these lessons now and you don't need to spend too much time on those, then of course remember you can go back and find previous lessons that you may have missed on the Consilium web page, that's their YouTube page. Again, links to this have been published for you in class charts. Okay, allora grazie mille, grazie di aver fatto la lezione. Thank you for doing the lesson with me today. Ci vediamo fra poco. See you soon. Ciao ciao.